Hello everyone, and welcome back to Oxygen Not Included. I'm Bricks and Hammers, and today we're going to be designing just a basic layout of what we want our next base to look like. For this episode or video, whatever, I'm going to be using the debug mode. If you've never used it, you can just make it work, because it doesn't work just like that. You have to make a text document in your game folder and just save it as debug underscore enable, and with that it doesn't have any text inside or anything, and with that you can you'll be able to do debug mode things. If you've wandered into the options, there's a whole tab of commands for debug mode. And you can use that. So we're going to be using that. We're not going to care about what our dupes are like, because we are not going to be really taking care of them. So with this debug mode, I already have it enabled. You have to enable it every time that you enter the game. I already had it, so it's working for me. You can see the whole map. You can move around with control F4. You can have instant build and build whatever you want with whatever material you want. With backspace, you enable it. Well, that's weird. Well, with backspace, you enable it. And that thing that popped out here is to like paint the environment. But I'm not really gonna worry about that. I'm just gonna start instantly building. And I sort of have an idea of what I want, but not quite. So what I know that I want is I want to take advantage of the most I can of this starting biome. Unfortunately, it's more like a circle. And I built like square bases. I guess a lot of people just build square bases, but what I want is just to have. I want to have my storage, like going all the way through here. So what I'm gonna do that with is I'm gonna put tiles, and then we'll delete them if we need to. We're going to make them granite so we can also see how our decor is going. We're going to need to dig that up. Those loops are going to help with that. And for our storage, I want them to just have two here. And like that. And then we're going to make two rows like that. And this is going to be already our normal flooring. And that way, this is going to be like our access to the outside world. And this is going to be the like limits of our base, I guess. Maybe we can do more like a circular thing. I don't know yet, guys. I'm not quite sure how we're gonna do this. So this is what I'm thinking, you know, like having like stairs right here, right next to it, and deconstruct that and deconstruct this, and this is gonna be our ladders. And I was thinking maybe we can just have it for the top like that. And then maybe have them like a little more in the side and have like three compartments here in the middle. Using debug mode, you know, might seem like cheating. And if you think so and don't want to use it, that's totally fine. I don't really consider it, because we're not really playing the game. And besides, you can do a lot of fun things with debug mode. There's this guy, Brothgar. He's doing all sorts of cool little things using debug mode, like challenges and more like you know, analyzing hypotheses and stuff like that. It's really cool and interesting. I totally recommend that. I was thinking maybe, okay, so this is these stairs are just gonna go up our whole floor up here. And then I was thinking we could have the bedrooms here, maybe the bathrooms over here, like the showers. Then we'll have like the kitchen over here. And I don't know what to put here. Maybe we could have like three compartments, or just three compartments over here. So I don't know. I always have normally just a big water basin down here, like right in the middle of the base. However, I've been thinking that maybe I should have two water basins, one for clean water and then one for polluted water. I'm only afraid of the polluted oxygen, but maybe we can just have like deodorizers, you know, whatever around there. So, all right. So I'm gonna keep working on this, and I'll check back when I have a little more going on here. Alright, so I made my clean water basin, and I'm gonna try to have this this dirty water basin basically right next to it. So we're gonna have clean water and then polluted water over here. For starters, I normally don't do this. I don't know. I think it might be a good idea. So we're gonna have maybe like stairs running through here, you know, or something of the like, so we can have access. Now you have to keep in mind that even though we're using debug mode to plan it out, we're gonna be dependent on the biomes around our starting biome for a lot of the things. So we're still gonna have to improvise a whole lot. In the real game, if there's a big cloud of chlorine down here, we won't be able to go as far in. We might have to change a few things, but at least we'll have, you know, something to aspire to in our real game, you know, indications of where to dig, what to do. So we're gonna do that in our real game. So my next step, I think, because I always like to have, and in my playthrough is going to be like that, first my water basin, just because I want to have a place to take all my clean water that I find in my biome, and know where to take it, you know, just so I don't have to deal with it, or, you know, whatever. Oh no, let's mop that up. Poor dupes. They don't even know what to do with themselves. They don't even have a bathroom. Jesus. Alright. So I think once this water clears out, I'm going to try and see how I can do the bedrooms. And I do think that I will do like bedrooms and then have maybe the showers. I want to have 20 dupes, so 20 beds. 20, not 20 showers, that'd be crazy, but maybe 10 showers, you know, two on each floor, so we can have the dupes, they will be using it, twice a day, because all the dupes, take a shower every day, or they try to anyway, so they will probably just, have one in the morning, and somebody else is gonna take it in the afternoon, or something like that. So we're gonna plan that out, and I'll check back in a bit with you guys. All right, so if we're gonna have 20 dupes, we could have 5 bets each level, 4 levels, you know, and then I said 10 before, but since we have 4 levels, it'd be 8 showers here, and that's pretty good. Here we're basically at the end of our biome. I put some insulated tile here because we do have an ice biome right here. Hopefully, we'll have something similar in our real playthrough with ice biomes right next to us, because I've had a couple maps where we just have swamp and the purple one, you know, just surrounding the whole place. So ice biomes are really good. They make you a little cold, and we should totally be aware of that too, because the dupes get cold. The briar seeds that we're gonna put, this is how I like decorating, with the briar seeds just in the bedroom, because I feel like you find just enough to put them here, and they make a lot of decor. And what I feel, I don't know if this is true, but I feel like, well, no, obviously the dupes do get less stressed when they sleep, but I think that the decor that has the effect of how much the stress is decreased. I'm not sure about that, but I think it should. I mean, it seems logical to think so, but I'm not sure. I know it decreases the decor around the base. What decreases, wait, hold on, let's see if they're gonna paint awful things, or do I have any artists here? Nope. Well, they're gonna get real good anyway. What was I saying? Jeez. I know for a fact that the decor around base reduces how much stress is generated. It says reduces duplicant stress, but I think it's it makes it, they make it so the stress increase is slower. I think that's what they actually do. So I don't know if it has any implication while they sleep, if it reduces it more or not. We're gonna spam our base with decorations, of course, so they can be real happy. And yes, I do plan this out, even in this mode, even when you're just doing the layout. Just wanna see if it's enough, or if we're gonna have to put more, or something. You see, so I like having these spaces around too, so we can just spam out art and for our dupes to be happier. All right, so now we have that. I think what I'm gonna be doing next is doing our oxygen plant up here. But first, what I was thinking is that just doing bathrooms here. You could have a bathroom in each level, and it's perfect because if they get up in the middle of the night to go to the bathroom a lot of the times, we can have the outhouses here. It's because it's on pause. It hasn't immediately built yet. Anyway, you could have the outhouses around here, and they also go to the bathroom right after they eat. So we would have our mess tables and kitchen on this side. So the bathrooms are right in the middle. I feel like that makes perfect sense. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that. Although, I was thinking we could do our farm here. So maybe we should have the fridge down here and then the mess tables on top. What do you guys think of that? That might be best, wouldn't it be? Yeah, I think that'd be best. All right, let's do it. That looks horrible, doesn't it? Just a big chunk of concrete. We also have to consider our kitchen because I like having an ongoing food supply, even though I have the blossoms. Just because, you never know when you're gonna need food. But I guess we could do it down here. We'll have nine. That's perfect. We're not gonna worry about that right now. It's gonna be an ugly base, for now. This is just the we just wanna see how it's gonna look like. And I don't really mind this. Whatever, whatever. Right? Right. We're also gonna be changing a lot for gas permeable tiles because we're gonna need to let our oxygen through. So what had I done before? One, two, three, four, and the fifth one. One, two, three, four, and the fifth one. In this case, I'm gonna put the hand sanitizer right in the middle. That looks cool. It's getting there, our base. We just need to decorate it a little more. I can't wait until this game comes out, and I hope they have a lot of more variety in these masterpieces things. It's kind of annoying how there's only one masterpiece where I just kind of wish they had more different funky things. Let's put some of these here. Maybe our dupes will have something to Oh, there's one that can't do art. What's that trait that you can't do art? You can't do art. Uncultured? Oh, and I never noticed that uncultured can't refuses to do art. Well, anyway. All right, so this is gonna be our top part. We are still missing our oxygen factory up here. Could do that. So I'm not really quite sure. I think this is gonna be just. I don't think we're gonna need more than two of these electrolyzers, and we're gonna be doing them in on both sides. This could be for our hydrogen generator. I'm just a little concerned about the temperature. It's already hot from this. But we could put it here if this was our map because we're gonna have to figure it out later. But we're gonna do the same thing on this side. That's what's important. All right,
we have the easy part, which is this one. Let's go to the second easiest part, which is the farm. And I'm gonna provide a medical wing, and that's gonna be down here. So just a little somewhere like this. We may have to do an extra level for it. And we're gonna have then hamster wheels, what is it called? Manual generators on this side and on this side, and we'll have our farm on this side. Let's see how it works out. And we're gonna have our special things like this that nobody ever uses, and our and the textile factory right here in the middle as well. But first, wow, it's cutting it close. Cutting it very close. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we would need. I don't know if this is gonna work. It's just too short. But I like how the two water basins look. I like that. I wish we could fit 5. Ah, that doesn't work out for me. We don't, if we fill this with polluted water, we're gonna want to not have it out in the open. That's why I'm doing this. But now it looks way worse, and I'm not quite sure that if in a normal map we would be able to go this far. We would, I don't know. We're gonna have to see if this whole thing works. This is fine, and we're moving already into the other biomes. It's just in the line. Look at all that algae. Delicious algae. Anyway. Yeah, this would be our top axis to the biomes up here. Our side axis. And this polluted water would ideally be here. And we could have a little pockets of carbon dioxide down here with an air scrubber. That'd be ideally, you know. But all right, let's keep doing this. What I was talking about before, having a pocket of carbon dioxide here, is basically just like that. And on this side, we're gonna have it too. And we're gonna have to put our decomposer somewhere. But I was thinking of doing that on this side and having the fertilizer makers maybe on that side. Maybe on this side. We're gonna have to see how much power we're gonna need. But I always feel like You need one for like base things. Then you need one for these, one for these. So that's three. And one for all these, which is four. Base things, I mean, you know, these, maybe some algae things. I was thinking like an algae thing here and an algae thing here. All right, let's do. And we would have our batteries and our coal generators on a nice biome. And we would just connect it through. And we would have ideally like on here and to connect to here and then here to connect to here. And our batteries would be there too. Alright, so this would be our farm. And now I just realized that we are gonna put all our hamster wheels here on this side, actually, because I just realized that, of course, it makes sense to have the fertilizers right next to the plants. So these are gonna be like just our emergency power sources, because each of these are gonna be connected to a cool generator, except for the one for our base. And here we're gonna put then we're also just gonna have two entrances. And this is gonna be from our showers. Now we're gonna put a water purifier. Oh, damn. Oh, everything was going so well, wasn't it? Ah. I guess this is gonna have to do. Alright, so this is what our base is gonna be trying to look like, and that's gonna be in our next episode. Oh, well, I mean, I didn't do it, but we would spam this whole place with mesh tiles so that the oxygen could go, could flow downwards. We would also put all sorts of gas vents around, you know. We would have this oxygen come down here, this oxygen up here. No, we don't really need that one. If we're short on oxygen, we can always turn on these. the algae deoxidizers. This would flow here. We would also put mesh tiles in here. We would make this one flow. We would make this one flow. We would put in a thermal regulator, maybe in the ice biome, since it overheats really quickly. We would also put, of course, two of these. And these. We will let them go here. Well, why don't we do it? Why don't we just do it, and we'll do the electricity too. I thought I was just gonna finish, but why don't we plan it out? Looking good, I like it. It's not too messy. And we have our water covered. Let's do our gas. I wonder if that works. It should work, right? I wonder. Anyway. So we're gonna let this go down here. Oh, that's not even what I wanted to do, was it? We're gonna deconstruct these. Now it should definitely work. I want this one to for this thing only. This will work for this section. This one will work for this section. So what do I do with this one? I'm just gonna adjoint it with this one. So, I was saying before that this would be the cold one. This would have to go through a whatchamacallit? A thermal regulator. But I mean, I don't feel like designing that. I just know that maybe it will be here, and then it would just go through all these, you know. And then also the power, like we would need to know where the generator, the cool generator is, and then connect it. I do know that one of these would be connected to this one. One of these would be connected to this. One of this would be connected to the algae deoxidizers, the cooking stations, the apothecary, the textile factory. The other one would be connected to these fertilizer makers, because they do take a lot of power to get them working. Oh, not that much. Maybe the fertilizers and the pumps and the air scrubbers. Yeah, you want to have like all your circuits with maybe just a little more of 1,000 kilowatts. Even though they can support 2,000, you don't really want to get to that point. Besides, you never know if you're gonna need to connect something else, and you're gonna need that extra little power there. So, this is it for this video. This is what I want my base to look like at the end of my next playthrough. Of course, we'll be digging and we'll be doing a lot of other things while we're building the base. But I just want to have an idea of where to start digging, how to start building my things when I start my next playthrough. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you all next time.